back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question, sent in by Hamilton, is about bingo. Yesterday's podcast, we had baseball. Now we have bingo. Hamilton says he wants to generate bingo numbers down column A, and he's figured out how to do that using the RAND function. Well, this formula, equal RAND, is going to generate a random number between 0 and 1. Simple enough. And so I'm guessing what Hamilton has done is he's used the integer of random times 90 plus 1 that will generate random numbers between 1 and 90 every time. Now, if you have the Analysis Toolpak turned on, that's under Tools, Add-ins, or if you're in Excel 2007, you could just use equal RANDBETWEEN to do the exact same thing. RANDBETWEEN 1, 90 will generate a random integer between 1 and 90. Very easy to use. But here's Hamilton's problem. He says, every time I generate a random number in column A, and I want to go to the next cell, all the previous numbers change. And so what we're going to do is we're going to set up a tiny little macro here that will basically find the next cell, put a random number in, and then convert the random number to a value. So to do this, we'll hit Alt F11 to switch over to VBA. We'll choose Insert Module. Just create a little routine here, sub draw number. First thing I want to do is I want to find the next blank cell. So I'm going to start at the bottom of the worksheet, rows.count, comma 1. Press the End key. And once I press the End key and the up arrow, I'm going to go to the last cell that has a value. I now want to go down one cell. So we'll use the offset function to go down one row over zero columns, and we'll select that cell. Now, once we've selected that cell, selection dot formula equals, and then in quotes, equal RANDBETWEEN 1, 90, close quotes. Okay, well, this will basically keep adding new random numbers down column A, but what we have to do is, once that random number has been entered, is convert it to a value. So selection.value equals selection.value, just a very easy way to do paste special values. So our macro here is called draw number. If I switch back to Excel and we go to Alt F8, I choose draw number and click options and assign this to a shortcut key, maybe Control D. And then now we can just hit Control D. It should give us a new number, 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 right on down the line. Of course, you see that number up there in cell A1 is still changing every time. We really should have started with a completely blank spreadsheet. And Control D, Control D, Control D, Control D, Control D. There you have it. Very simple way to create bingo numbers. Of course, now the problem with this is we still might have duplicates, and it would take a very long podcast to go through and figure out how to get rid of the duplicates, although certainly possible. I'm guessing Hamilton's just going to deal with the duplicates and draw a new number if one happens to pop up. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.